Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
My name's Paula Joanna. I imagine you might, my daughter's name might ring a bell with you. Her name is Sabina Rose.
Go ahead.
December 2nd, you made a speech about you won't expand the medical marijuana program. In the very hour you did that, I took my baby off a ventilator. She died from Dravet syndrome. She had a 24-hour seizure. This is what happens when you don't get the proper medical marijuana program installed in the state. You mentioned before that maybe you have to force these dispensaries to provide it, and that's exactly what you need to do.
Well, listen, first of all, let me say, yes, I do know your daughter's name, and I'm horribly sorry for what's happened to your daughter. And this program, as it was put together when it was originally sent to me, didn't provide for what you're talking about. We then changed it to allow edibles to come in last year, in the summer. We had no way of knowing that they would not produce the edibles. So I'm saying to you now what I said to the woman over there. As we see problems in the program, we'll try to fix it. But the bill that was sent to me by Governor Corzine on the day of my inauguration didn't provide for this. We then saw the problem, worked with the legislature, we compromised, we authorized edibles for minors. Now we're finding that dispensaries are not producing the edibles because they don't make a profit for them, because there's not enough of a demand. So now we have to go back and see, do we have to, in fact, as a condition of the license, force them to do it?
Yes.
But every time we do this, just understand that every time we do this, it makes it less and less likely that these people want to be in business, because they're in business to make money. And that's why I originally urged a hospital-based program, which was not authorized in the bill that the legislature approved. So we're continuing to try to help to figure this out. I didn't think you're going to have to force people to produce something. Now, we're seeing that we may have to. But understand that if we do that, the reaction that may be that some of them may decide to close if it's not profitable. So I completely sympathize with you. I can't possibly imagine what you're going through as a parent of four. I can't imagine it, to feel helpless to help your child. And I'm trying to get to a place where we can do this. But if I legalized marijuana tomorrow, that wouldn't make there to be edibles. If I did, but I'm trying to figure out a problem to fix it in a way that will actually bring help to children who are having the suffering that your child had.
I did a lot of my own research with my husband. We've talked to dispensary owners. We know what works and what doesn't. We knew my daughter, we started the process of getting her medical marijuana card in August. She still didn't have it in November because of all the roadblocks. I put her to bed one night and she never woke up. She suffered a 24-hour seizure. The day that I put her to bed was the day her application was supposed to be submitted. The doctors on the medical marijuana program need to be trained. Some of them shouldn't even be on that list. Like, the things that we went through to try to get my girl this card, it took so long and she ran out of time. I have a 5-month-old son going to the ICU. She was put in a coma. She was in it for 5 days. I had a 2-month-old baby. My life is so difficult because I don't have her. And it could be easily solved. My husband and I know many solutions. We have great suggestions.
Well,
I call your office constantly, and I don't get any response. I deserve an hour of your time one-on-one.
Well, an hour of my time one-on-one would do... Listen, if I thought that giving you an hour of my time one-on-one would solve this problem all by itself, no, I'd give it to you.
It wouldn't. But it would make my husband and I feel better. I voted for you twice. I live here my whole life. My daughter's only been to the shore once. She's only been to a park once. She had one birthday party, one Christmas. One.
I understand, and I know, and we're trying to fix the problem. And we will sit down with you and work with you to get your suggestions, like we're getting from lots of parents who are in your situation, who my staff has met with and has taken suggestions from. But the one thing I would respectfully disagree with you about is that if the problem was easy to solve, it would be solved. And it's not easy to solve. I understand, but I want you to know that people hear it that way.
No, I didn't mean it that way.
And so let's work together to try to solve it. And it'll be Jean Ashmore, who's right over standing up against the wall there, who's the head of my constituent relations. We'll set up time for you to come down, sit with us, tell us about your experience, and we'll try to work with the legislature to fix the problem. But this is what happens, and this is not your problem, but you're suffering from it. When a bill gets passed on the day before the new governor's being sworn in, gets signed into law in the middle of the night, nobody thinks about what the effects are going to be of it. They don't think it through. They just go ahead and do it. And so I'm left to fix that problem. I'm going to fix the problem. We've made it better than it was before. And if there's ways that you can show us I can make it better, as long as it stays as a medically based program, I don't have any objection to it. When I say I'm not going to expand marijuana in the state, so that you're clear about this, what I mean is I'm not going to decriminalize or legalize. But I have said, and I proved last summer, that if there are changes that need to be made that will help to get people who are truly sick care that they need, I'm open to making those changes. But what I fear is that a lot of people, not you, but folks who are advocates, as I said to the woman before, use really tragic circumstances as an excuse to say, well, let's just legalize. So I've got to walk that line, but I'm ready to walk that line with you. And I wish that what had happened to you hadn't happened.
Me too.
I can't prevent it, but we're going to try to make sure that it doesn't happen to you or to anybody else again, and we'll continue to work with you on it.
Okay.
Thanks. Thank you.